Don't listen to people that are going to tell you that you can't do it. Don't listen to haters. Don't listen to naysayers. Don't listen to people that give you advice that tell you to slow down or you shouldn't do it or you can't do it or the time's not right or any of those other things. Those are dream stealers.
Hey guys, today we are going to harvest some potatoes in this grow bag. So I thought I would show you the process. Okay, so you can see there's already some right here at the top. Doesn't really require much digging. I'm just gonna dump it. Hopefully this is a good idea. Oh yeah, runaway potato. Don't eat that. Don't you dare. Okay. I just feel like that's the easiest way to do this. Okay. So we've got a little guy. What else? Story, you wanna help me? We gotta find the potatoes. Here's a big one. Yeah, tell us. It's another one. So, we've got some chickens helping us dig. but luckily, they don't really like potatoes. So it's not, I'm not really worried about that. Okay, so one little grow bag. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. Like a little bit. Some little ones.
This is how we do it.
We just doubled the size of our strawberry garden, and it only took a quarter of the space because we went vertical with these Dollar Tree towers. We were able to plant 504 strawberry plants, and we did it using these planters. They're very brittle, and all the TikTok videos I saw used a drill, and a drill just shatters them. So I saw another video where it looked like they were melting them, so I ran to the home improvement store, found a pipe that was the right size. And when you heat the pipe nice and hot, it just melts them like butter and makes a beautiful hole. Just don't push too hard when you do it, because if you push too hard, it can still break. Once I got good at it, I could do up to 7 at a time. And then this is just a tent stake that I used, and it just pops right through. And it makes these beautiful holes without breaking it at all. And so I think this is much better. A drill is not gonna work. It's just gonna make a mess. So look at that. It turned out beautifully. And so then we set about planting them. It was a cold week this week, but we got them all done, spent lots of time outside. I've got organic fertilizer. I have potting soil, and I have all of our strawberry planters from Dollar Tree. I'm just filling them. I found that a 2 cubic foot compressed bag of garden soil, once it was fluffed up, would fill 2 towers. And we have 12 of these stacked in each tower on the T-post. So we planted and we planted and we planted until we got them all done. And it was a fun project. It was a little time consuming, but once we got better at it, it went a lot faster. And once 2 of us were doing it, it went super fast. You do lose a little soil when you're putting it onto the T-post, so we backfilled a little as necessary. Usually the top one needed a little soil and the bottom one needed a little soil, but here's the ends. Here's our existing garden beds. There's 4 long beds already there, and then 14 towers ready to go. We can't wait for spring. Each tower with the plant, soil, fertilizer, everything, T-post was $27. So that's a real.
Here's a tip for growing strawberries. The first year of growing strawberries, you should let the plant focus on its leaves and the roots. So I'm just gonna cut off all the flowers and strawberries that are on there. I know this might seem tough, but it'll help you grow a lot of strawberries in the future. Like for more tips.
This is an easy DIY hack for seeding carrots. Carrot seeds are extremely small, which makes them hard to sow. Cut newspaper into strips about 1/2 inch wide, and then add a little bit of flour to some water to make it kind of a paste. Add a drop of the paste to the strip about 1 inch apart, and then take those tiny little seeds. I use a toothpick to just pick them up and drop them onto the little dot. Once these start to grow, you can thin out every second one for baby carrots. Combine the strips together to make them longer. The little flour dots are now dry, and it's time to roll these up. So I just take a paper towel holder and start rolling them about 6 inches apart. I use a broken ruler to push down about 1/2 inch trench, a couple rocks at the end to hold it stable, and just unroll it. Cover them up, and now you have perfectly spaced carrots. You're welcome.
It's time to murder some strawberry flowers.
I just put in the strawberry bed.
They're ever-bearing strawberries.
That means they'll fruit maybe 2-3 times a year.
And these little flowers are what becomes the strawberry.
So why am I chopping them off?
It's because I need more of these leaves.
For ever-bearing strawberries, you want to take off all of the flowers until about July.
That lets the plant focus on producing leaves.
So it's time to say goodbye, Paezi.
Burying a clay face in my garden. In you go.
No.
Let's cover her up. Pop off the top and start filling. Water seeps out of the porous clay in about a 2-foot radius for passive irrigation.
How to grow an endless supply of mint. When you harvest, cut right above a node. Now these two stems will bush out. When cloning, cut right below.
Chop off the bottom leaves, pop in water to root, and replant. So we have a standard Spanish lavender right here. And then as you take the side shoots off, it starts to look like this as you just leave the top growth. And if you just let that process continue and you keep snipping it off, check this out. But then look at this, the final product, which is the lavender tree, which looks absolutely amazing. And you can see hundreds of them right here. Beautiful pollinator plant, probably making its way out to a big box store somewhere, a local nursery, but just a really cool way to prune and train these lavender.
Part two with this cool planter. We're gonna plant some strawberries and I've also got some herbs. The soil is ready, let's go. The holes are already poked through and they've put this little reservoir bottom on. I've tested it and the overflow comes out. Ready for a new home. That was an exciting find. There were two in there. I repeated it on this one. And the third one had two plants as well. In the last hole, I'm gonna plant these strawberry roots my neighbor gave me. Let me tell you about them. These strawberry roots went dormant, and so now if you soak them in water and put them in soil, in about 3 weeks, they'll sprout. So we'll see how that goes. Here's one of the roots. We're just gonna make a hole and plant it in the soil. I left a little piece of the top showing, but it's in there. Now for the next one. Here's the next one. Last one. Time to stack. I'm gonna start with 3 layers for now, but check this out, we've already got a berry. I'm gonna plant the herbs next, but like and follow to see more of my container garden.
Look how many new strawberry plants I got from Brunner's. Can you guess how many they are? This runner planted itself in the ground. Now let's put them in the garden. We mixed bone meal into the soil before planting. It's been about 2 months since we got our first plant from a runner. Oh my gosh, look at that worm. A total of 14 new strawberry plants. All thanks to this queen mother.
What is happening here? This is a Cosmo. It usually looks like this, or like this,
or even like this.
But I've never seen one looking like this.
New project, hair conditioner from plants growing in my garden. Let's see how it goes.
Rose petals promote new hair growth and make your hair nice and shiny.
Rosemary prevents graying and hair loss by increasing the blood supply to your scalp.
Marshmallow and field mallow are rich in mucilage, which helps to detangle knotty hair, making it a great conditioner.
Aloe gel opens up blocked pores, which promotes the growth of new hair follicles.
Mint also promotes hair growth, but it reduces itchiness and inflammation.
Parsley soothes the scalp, helps with inflammation, and enhances hair color.
Sage helps with scalp dryness and adds depth and shine to your hair.
And this pineapple sage smells incredible.
Chamomile to soothe and strengthen the scalp.
Time to rinse these off.
Now that they're rinsed, I can add the herbs back to the water and start mixing and mashing to infuse the water with all their plant goodness.
Now let's get on to these aloes.
Let's add the aloe, mash it all up some more, then I'll pop the lid on
and leave it here overnight.
I made this face cream from plants I've got growing in my garden.
Mint cools, soothes, and cleanses the skin, and it prevents acne and wrinkles.
Sage is a powerful antioxidant that cleanses oily skin, prevents acne, and reduces wrinkles.
And this pineapple sage smells wonderful.
Thyme is really good at preventing and clearing acne due to its antiviral, antifungal, antiseptic, and antibiotic properties.
Rosemary is good for both oily and dry skin.
It prevents acne and helps with anti-aging.
Calendula is a skin healer
that can soothe sunburns, treat acne,
great for both oily and dry skins.
Rose petals revitalize the skin,
which prevents wrinkles and clears acne.
Let's give the herbs a good rinse. Let's
give them a little bit of time on the windowsill to dry.
Let's add a tub of plain aqueous cream to our planty mixture.
That looks pretty yummy, to be honest.
Let's pop our pot into a pot of boiling water and put a lid on top.
This way we can heat up the cream without burning the herbs.
A teeny bit chunky, but it worked! Let's try it.
Smells great.
Yay.